And it's probably afternoon. I'm late. But welcome. Welcome to another early morning show. Glad that you could drop by. Up really late last night. I had to stay up to watch my football team, Nebraska, lose again by 3 points. Again to a ranked team. God, it's so heartbreaking. They find a way to lose. They find a way to lose. God, they played like champs. Ah, gee whiz. But that's college football. So, hey, the way it is. God bless it. So, yeah, I stayed up late. And I'm off to a little later start. I didn't wake up to after 5:30. No, 4:30. But it's about 5 now. It doesn't matter. Welcome. Last week, I talked about this pink I'd been going through. And And I had some of you, I had some texts, and some comments, and you said, there's some people in the medical profession out there, doctors and that, they said, hey, that's not pink eye, you got something else, and you need to go back in and have it looked at. So I did, and sure as hell, it was not pink eye, and that medication for pink eye really hurt. I mean, really burned when I was putting it in, and it was something else that is a little more serious than that and needed a couple of different types of medication, steroids. So I have an eye on steroids, but on the good news is I don't see as much black float. The black floaty stuff's about all gone now. I mean, it was just, I'm swatting bugs all over the place, and it's starting to clear up. Hey, we're moving in the right way. So excited about that. And that's about it. Hopefully it's going to be a beautiful day. I haven't mowed my yard in 2 weeks because it's been so much rain. I mean, incredible amount of rain. Not supposed to rain today. So I know I got to mow, but I want to play golf. But let's begin. I want a couple channel shout outs. One I just started watching. He commented on one of my videos and mentioned that he had one. I didn't know. Again, if you're watching my videos, you've never heard from me, let me know you have a channel, please. Just tell me. And that way I can come and watch your video. But it was a Smell the Vinyl. Smell the Vinyl. And I'm not sure of his name. He said, I'm just another old guy in a t-shirt talking records. Hey, I'm an old guy in a t-shirt. I'm talking records too. I thought that was pretty humorous. And he has 79 subs. You know, he had one. He talks about his, he bought a record store in the 90s and goes through that, Beatles fan and, you know, kind of a, again, his journey with records and what he's looking at. So nice. It's, he's well-spoken, good at kind of telling a story. So it's Smell the Vinyl is the name of the channel. The other one is called Movies and Grooves, Movies and Grooves. And it's by a guy that's, he's been in the VC, but started this new channel, Namain. It used to be Jamon. I think he changed his name because he can't say it right, obviously. I believe Namain, you're from Korea. But he started this where it is movies, but it's also records. Just one of the happiest people I've ever met. And he just started this channel. I'm not sure if he even has 10 subs. So check that out. Movies and Grooves. Namain. And tell him Steve sent you. I like him. He's one of these guys that I hope to someday be able to meet. When I was in D.C., I wanted to, but we didn't have time. So, but let's begin with another VC member that just put out a record album. And the record album is from Michael P Dawson, and it's called Rat's Alley. Isn't that great artwork? Really, really love this artwork on this album. And it came in kind of a lilac type color. So Michael P Dawson, he does have a channel, and it's well worth checking out. He is a multi-instrumentalist. He did almost everything on here. I think there was just one thing he didn't do. But, you know, he plays alto, bass, and concert flute, soprano, and tenor saxes, oboe, bass clarinet, moog, synthesizers, guitar, bass, mandolin, glockenspiel, virtual instruments, and electronics. Nah, sounds like he did it all. And he worked on this during the pandemic when he was inside. This is Michael's fifth album, and his music is more... There's definitely a prog rock to it, electronic, experimental. He does these wonderful soundscapes, really cool stuff. You know, I never quite know where to drop Michael in my collection as far as, you know, when I line it up and decide genres. Right now, hey, Michael, you're in jazz, okay? But yet it's not jazz. This, I really like this album. I think this is Ice's fifth album, his best yet. This can be found on Bandcamp. The first side, he has, like, it starts with Division Street. I'll play a little sample of that. It's fun and it's bouncy. But my favorite was a song called Cooties. And Cooties is just a joy. It's one of these songs you listen to and just puts a smile on your face. I remember Cooties growing, you know, in school, in the 70s, you know, or, late 60s. Oh, he has Cooties, which I kind of lice or whatever, but Cooties was bad. And if you want to make, you know, some kid cry, just tell me you have Cooties. I didn't cry on that, though. It was a really, really good song. And so side one, it's a variety of songs, but I found them to be quite joyful, very, just have this upbeat feel. Now, side two is a concept, and he takes T.S. Eliot's The Wasteland. I've never read, you know, I'm not a huge T.S. Eliot fan, but The Wasteland is considered one of the premier modern poems that was made, okay? It kind of changed the direction of poetry, put it into the modern age. And so it's based upon that. Now, not reading the poem, I wouldn't know what the heck's going on, but the music had a flow to it. So you could tell Michael was working on this concept on the second side, because it really, it made sense how the music was going. And you could feel we're following some type of story that I did not know. This was very good. For me, he did Paleozoic. I really enjoyed that one. But this Rat's Alley was just, I found it just, you know, considering it did during the COVID, I just found some of the songs to be uplifting. And really, again, it did, I totally enjoyed it, and I've played it a number of times. So it's Rat's Alley is the name of it, from Michael P. Dawson. I mean, check out his YouTube channel. I think it's great. He is extreme knowledgeable, and then on Bandcamp, check it out. And you could probably even look at his channel. He may have it, you know, when you go to the information. It's probably something there on it. So Rat's Alley, really nice. Michael, when I bought that though, and so he sent it out from his place, and I bought through Bandcamp, but he included here we have Rock and Roll Hoochie Coo by The Who. Is that neat? A very neat, nice bootleg. This was, it sounded great. Good sound quality to it. It's from a 1973 concert on there. It has four of the different songs. So great stuff. Really enjoyed it. Actually, it has one, two, it's about eight songs. So that was a fun listen. And then Steve Reich, I didn't take that out. And so I'm going to sneeze here just a minute, if you don't mind. Excuse me. Okay, maybe I'll edit that out, but I probably won't. Tehillim. I know Steve Reich. I had a few of his works. He is a modern composer, experimental modern composer. Excuse me. I'm not allergic to Michael's album, pretty sure. And this had some vocals in it. This is something different. I'm still wrapping my head around this one. It's off ECM. But I've enjoyed the music of Steve Reich, so I was very, very excited to see this. Actually thrilled. So thank you, Michael, for those two additional albums. Another artist just put out a brand new album that I bought that I enjoy. And this is Dean Wareham. He put this out. And the name of the album is I Have Nothing to Say to the Mayor of L.A. Isn't that just a long title, huh? A mouthful to say. I Have Nothing to Say to the Mayor of L.A. So this is his brand new album. It just came out maybe a couple weeks ago. Wareham, he was born in 63 in New Zealand. He moved to Australia and he came to the U.S. in 77. He went to school at Harvard and he met some people there. Isn't that nice? You go to school and you meet some people. Ooh, really? And they formed a band called Galaxy 500, named after the Ford Galaxy 500. It's a band that I love. I think it's a wonderful band. Kind of there's some, you know, you think of like Spaceman 3, a similar, but yet this is in a slower kind of a feel, more of a shoegazy kind of a noise, but it's mellower. And you can kind of hear because, you know, Galaxy 500, they were around from, when was it? Till 91. I think they formed in like 87 to 91. He then formed the band Luna in 91. That went to 05. Luna is one of my favorite bands of the 05. I mean, of the 90s. It is dream pop. It is beautiful dream pop. And some of the best albums of the 90s came from Luna. It was a wonderful box set. And I saved all the vinyl from that box set because it's one of my favorite bands. Well, he then, after 05, him and the bass player, Britta Phillips, who was his wife now, they began making music as Dean and Britta. But they have also made separate solo albums, and this is one of them here. So it's rockier than what you would find on a Luna album. But yet you still have that same kind of feel on beautiful red vinyl. There is just some wonderful songs on here. It's filled with these chimey guitars. Britta Phillips does the background singing. When those two sing together, it's absolutely gorgeous. One of the songs I'm going to play, it is, Cashing In. And, the lyrics go, I'm not selling out, I'm cashing in. Gorgeous, gorgeous song. I absolutely, really, really enjoyed it. This is a really enjoyable, if you like that dreamy kind of sound. You know, he doesn't have a voice that's this big, gruff voice. No, his voice is, it just floats. I guess would be a nice way to say it. And it takes you to another place in a quiet way. Enjoyed this album, was glad I got it. Dean Wareham, and I Have Nothing to Say to the Mayor of LA, to LA. I keep looking at the side, it's right there. Maybe my eye, I don't see it, I don't know. But it's made in Canada. Go Canada. All right, good stuff. I used to think then. Hold on. Sold out of my mugs. I have more coming. I have more people want them. I did buy some more mugs, and I did get some more t-shirts coming. They're all gone. Thank you for those that wanted to have something in your house that make your kids go, well, what the hell's wrong with you? What's that about? Another app. So this is a brand new reissue. Name of the group is Iron Claw. I am Iron Claw. Bum, 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 bum. There is a tie to this. They're from Scotland. They formed in 69, broke up in 71. So let's just say things didn't quite work out for Iron Claw. The band actually started, they went and they saw a Led Zeppelin concert in 69. And when they left that concert, they said, let's form a band. And they did. They were so excited. But then they went later in 69, saw another concert, Black Sabbath. Blew them away. They came back and totally redid the feel of the band to sound like Black Sabbath. That was that exciting to them. And they're when they began touring, they would just play the very first Black Sabbath album. They just come in. They were the very first Black Sabbath cover band. I mean, that album was still just, I mean, Black Sabbath still learned how to play them, and they're playing it awesome. So they never made an album, but they did demos, and they had different things, and I guess they got the master's tapes. This was a CD that came out in 09, and so this is the first time I think the CD's been put on vinyl. So it is, the music changes, because even though they were only around 2 years, they began to revolve, you know, with people. So you could tell, you know what, they're not making it well. People are saying, oh, screw it. Let me just go do something else. And so they began moving. So it is the first, it also there's demos and stuff. So some of it, the recording, you could tell they went in and, they're having a hard, I mean, the rooms were too small and they were playing too large, so you get this distortion. And I think on the sample, you'll hear some of that, pictures of the band. So I would say the first album, you can really feel the heaviness of Black Sabbath in there and what they're trying to do and to try to kind of copy that feel. But the second album, yes, you know, we never put out an album yet. We got two albums worth of material. They turned more toward a jam band. They began to change. Free, I would say, became a group that they began to listen to. Some of the other hard rocking, more jammy type bands. So the music changes on the second album. So the first one really doomy, Sabbathy kind of a feel to it, and the second one you get more of a jam happening, and you can even see. Well, no, actually the songs are smaller there. Forget it. Whatever I was going to say, screw it. So, not a bad album. For those that like the heavy rock, you will probably like this. The quality is not the top. I mean, it doesn't sound awful, but you could tell, you know, there were some issues. Again, they were never able to get an album put out. You know, is it my normal fare? No, but I gave it a shot. So one of you, I don't know, Blue Seal, did you tell me to go buy that? Someone told me, hey, check that out. And I found it on Bomb, if I remember right. I think I did. So Iron Claw. Another brand new reissue. This has been reissued a number of times, and it is, you can find it out, Fania label. They did a colored vinyl version, but that one sold out. So this is from Willie Colon and Ruben Blades. This is Salsa. This, when this was made, in 1978, it sold 3 million copies. It was the number one selling salsa album, and it was that way for many, many years. This is an album of joy. That the two people, Willie Colon, he came from New York, but his parents were from Puerto Rico, was a trombone player, born in 50. At age 17, he did his first album, sold 300,000 copies. How good he was. Ruben Blades, he came out of Panama. Blades, yeah. Blade, just Blade. Maybe I didn't say his wrong. No, Blades. He came out of Panama, born in 48, and he's a vocalist. He wrote the material, and then Willie Colon came and did the and did the arrangements for it. It makes you want to jump up. It makes you want to dance. It makes you want to learn how to salsa. You know, there is like Dime on here. Now that is a more of a slow song. There are some mid-tempo salsa songs, but some of it is just beautiful. If you were to listen to a salsa channel, they're going to play music from this. Siembra means sowing in Spanish. And they're really sowing some great seeds of salsa. I've wanted this album for a long time. It had sold out when it was first coming, but they finally got some more back in on the reissue of this. I love the feel of salsa music, the joy and the happiness that surrounds salsa music. And this did not let me down. Joyful music. That's what it is. And don't we all need music like that? When we just put on and makes you smile, makes you want to get up and just yeah. Then we came, it's a double. This group's been on my want list ever since this album came out. This was the very first album from Amyl, am I saying that right? And the Sniffers. It's named after Amyl nitrate. I'm sure I'm saying that wrong. Like I would say any of that. I know what the stuff is. You sniff it and yeah, as even they quoted and say, hey, we're just like that drug. You sniff us for 30 seconds, you're high, and then you have a headache. So that's kind of how they explain their music. So the first one here, I mean, the group, they formed in 2016, and their first album here came out, their self-titled came out 2019 out of Australia. Punk / rock, shall we say. You know, this was so well received in the VC. Everybody was showing it but me. I thought about getting it. Again, it's only so much money. Dave Local Bandography, another one of my absolute favorite channels because he makes me spend money. He was secretly telling me if I don't buy these albums, I'm a moron and I can't even say I like punk music. So it was his peer pressure. Then I went out and, well, why buy one? I'll just buy them both, okay? So the lead singer is Amy Taylor. And she has that punk scream. She has that punk feel. It's there. There's the rage to her music. And you really, really felt this. This is punkier. I think on here, they get heavier. You know, there is, there's feels of blues rock, you know, and the, when you kind of think of X or Gun Club, that kind of feel. Some of it's even heavier, almost like a Motorhead type feel to the music. This came on. Came on beautiful orange vinyl. That other color, what the hell color is that? I don't even know. And so this is the brand new one, Comfort to Me, that just came out. last few weeks ago, and a lot of people have shown it, and they've shown it for good reason. It is a very, very good album for those that like to punk. They salute you. Again, I think this is more punky than this. This rocks hard. It really, it just takes off and goes. So definitely a little more hardcore. I'll rock to that. So both albums, well worth it. I would highly recommend. Really enjoyed it. Just took me a while to get to the party. Thank you, Dave. Final one. That was from us. Oh, the Ray Beats. Yeah, I said Australia. The Ray Beats are out of New York City. Formed in 79, broke up in 84. Surf guitar music, but a little bit different. They call themselves Neo Surf Rock. It's an instrumental album. And this was their very first album, Guitar Beat. Fun stuff. You know, it's surf music's fun music show. I mean, that's just what it's all about. And this is no exception. They came from a couple groups. One of the groups it came from was called the Contortions, and the other was Eight-Eyed Spy. And they got together. And so really what they do, I mean, they make these kind of simple melodies, but with these sparkling guitars. It's a lot of fun. They got a kind of a jaunty type organ. It's a different organ feel, and a wailing sax going on. So you just get that feel. It's really an expensive album, but it's just fun stuff. For those that like surf rock, but you want something newer, this was in 81, it was made, you know, a Guitar Beat. Is that really new? When you think 60s surf, yeah, it is, but hell, that's over 40 years now. Jesus, wow. The Ray Beats. That's all we got for the week. Appreciate you. I got my Dean Wareham. This is from Dean Wareham's previous album. Obviously, I'm a fan of him. Thank you, everyone, for taking your time to watch. And appreciate it. There'll be something midweek, I'm sure. I don't even know. I don't have anything planned yet, but we'll get something figured out. I had a lot of last week. 3 videos. Wow. But they're ones I needed to get done. Thanks for tuning in. Looking forward to seeing you again. Have a great week. Bye.